coronavirus. Everybody's scared, right? Well, no, not everybody's scared. You would think that everybody's scared, and you would think that everybody's dying. The way that it's being portrayed, it's like that there's another black plague, and this is it, and most of the world is gonna die. But they're not. Really, it's okay. You don't have to be scared just because they tell you to be scared. I remember when I was a kid, it was Y2K, and I was just going around business like usual. But then somebody was, you know, got real panicky about it. Oh, all these bad things are gonna happen, and I didn't know I was supposed to be scared. So I said, "Am I supposed?" So I went to my parents. I said, "Dad, am I supposed to be scared? Is this scary?" And he said, "No. Probably the things that they say is gonna happen probably won't even happen." Oh. Okay. So now, 20 years later, now we're teaching our kids, yes, be afraid, run in fear, let your life be governed by fear. Well. Okay. That's an idea. You know, that definitely is an idea. Now it's the other way around. People don't realize that they don't have to be scared. They think they have to be afraid. Some people have been afraid so long that they don't even know how to not be afraid. And I tell you this, I have had anxiety issues all my life. So now, you know, the tables have turned. I'm totally completely calm. I'm obviously, you know, doing the same thing I always do when I don't want to catch the cold or the flu and that kind of stuff. You know, wash your hands, that kind of stuff. People are gross. You'd be surprised how many people go poop without washing their hands. Now, regardless of whether you get sick from that or not, I don't even care. That's gross. I mean, wash your hands, you filthy creature. It's like I saw somebody say the other day, there's this part in James where it says, "Wash your hands, you sinners." Anyways, you gotta laugh about stuff, especially when people are so about it. Like at my funeral, I don't want people to be sitting around in a room crying about stuff. I mean, goodness sakes, I would much rather people get together somewhere comfortable and just say, "Hey, you know, let's have a good time. Let's play some games or something." You know, goodness sakes. You know. Anyways, so now people are at the point where they don't know, they don't have to be scared. And they think that this thing is a lot worse than what it really is. I'm really kind of surprised. So let's look at this. The coronavirus, you know. Yeah, maybe I should be more serious about this. The coronavirus and why it will probably not kill you. So I do want to kind of point out a few things that I personally think are more funny. And so I'm not saying them to make you feel stupid or to, you know, look down at people, but I think that it's so funny. You know, everybody's all, "Oh, love and peace. But then the media says, "Epidemic." And now everybody, oh, the gloves are off now. I mean, people are buying up the toilet paper. They're not sharing. They're buying up the wet ones where moms don't even have wet ones to wipe their own baby's butts because everybody's so scared about this coronavirus. What happened to all the love and peace? I thought we were all, you know, had each other's backs and stuff. And somebody commented on one of the things, I think it was on my blog, and they said, "It's just human nature to watch out for each other and to be loving and that kind of stuff." And I was like, have you ever been in a school project? And this is a perfect example. Everybody talks about love and peace until there's some great tragedy. And then they're like, "Oh, no, no more love and peace. Now it's time to freak out." And it's just not – it's not time to freak out. Yeah, it's really fine. Now, I do want to say this. Christians must be loving and selfless, especially in these times. No matter what people in the world are doing, it's important that Christians don't buy up all the toilet paper. Leave some for other people. Goodness sakes, guys. You know, maybe even give away some of the toilet paper that you have to people who are less off. You know what I mean? Instead of hoarding all this stuff for your own self, watch out for other people. You know, there's some people who are living on the streets, and do you think that they are ever even able to take a shower, let alone wipe off their hands? See, people, typical people who eat healthy or in good physical shape, who aren't, you know, excessively elderly, you know, and they're just healthy people. They eat healthy. They do minimal exercise. I mean, these people, they're going to be fine. Even if they do catch it, it's really not going to be that big of a thing. It's those people who don't have the means to go out and buy up the Purell. They're the people who are mostly being ill impacted by this. In my state, New Mexico, there are, as of today, zero confirmed cases of the coronavirus, and the entire state's economy is shut down. There are a few presumptive cases, I believe 10 or 13, I don't forget which, presumptive cases, but they haven't been confirmed. So everybody's freaking out, and the entire state is on shutdown. I mean, school canceled and all kinds of stuff because people are scared that they might. I mean, let's just stop for a second and say, guys, hey, hold on. I think maybe we're overreacting here. It's a global thing. Do you know that the cold is a global thing? There's no cure for it. There's no cure for the cold either. Now, I know people are going to say, no, the two things are very different. I know that. I know they're different. But the principle that I'm trying to say is very similar. You know, anyways, the moral of the story being here, be loving to people during this time. Don't be hateful to people because you're scared. You know, watch out for their best interests, not your own. It's easy to say, oh, I love people or whatever when things are easy, but when it's hard to love someone, that's when it really shows your love. So let's look at a few things. First off, it is very surprising how quickly Americans have completely abandoned their freedom. Everybody wants to talk about freedom this and freedom that, but then the instant that somebody says anything about epidemic, now all of a sudden everybody's just like, I don't care about freedom anymore. Take whatever you want. You can own me as a person. I will sell myself into slavery. Just keep me safe from the coronavirus. Okay. Yes, there are people who have died from the coronavirus. However, we're not talking about 100% fatality. There is less than 4% mortality rate globally. What I mean by globally is we are including areas where they don't have good health, areas where they don't have good hygiene, areas where they don't have good doctors. Globally. Now let's do the math here. If there are 400 people who get the coronavirus, 4% of that 400 would be 16 people. Think about this. Just stop for a second, think about this. Less than 16 of the 400 would die. And typically, only if they were excessively old or were in poor health. So that brings us to the issue of, if you have, you know, autoimmune problems or anything like that, here's the thing. You should be practicing good hygiene all the time. Don't live in fear, though. Practice good hygiene, but don't live in fear. Worst case scenario, you die. It's okay. It's all right. We're all going to die anyways. There's no reason to die in fear. We're not animals. Goodness sakes. So wash your hands. Be smart. Yes, absolutely. Don't try and infect people. Don't do that. Oh, my goodness. There's some people who are, well, we're going to get it anyways. We might as well just go. It's like, well, okay, let's calm down with that. So there is an element in us that is always afraid of the unknown. That's just human nature. A lot of people are scared not necessarily of death itself, but maybe the fear of approaching the unknown, not knowing what's coming after the moment of... I mean, death really doesn't take that long. Even when you are sick and dying from the sickness, like cancer or something like that, the actual death process itself is only a moment. Now, the progressive death that leads to that finality may be long and painful, but ultimately death itself is just a very quick thing. So typically people aren't really afraid of death itself. It's the unknown that they're afraid of. The idea of wasting away in a bed, unneeded and unwanted. That's usually something that maybe people would be scared of. Or what happens after I take my final breath? Will it hurt? Will it be scared? Will I die in fear? Will I not be able to run away from the impending? See what I mean? And so there's this fear of the unknown. Now let's look here at this is I misspelled corona there, but this is the symptoms of the coronavirus. Okay, are you ready? Coronavirus disease COVID-19 is characterized by mild symptoms, including a runny nose, sore throat, cough, and fever. This is just like the thing we get every year with the colds and the flus and all that stuff, okay? Illness can be more severe for some people and can lead to pneumonia or breathing difficulties. Okay? not really the end of the world there. Once again, though, if you have pre-existing lung conditions like asthma, it might be a little more severe. More rarely, the disease can be fatal. Older people and people with other medical conditions, such as asthma, right? What did I just say? Diabetes or heart disease may be more vulnerable to becoming severely ill. To becoming more severely ill, not to dying, necessarily. People may experience runny nose, sore throat, cough, fever, difficulty breathing in severe cases. This isn't the regular occurrence. So now that we looked at that, it's really not that scary. Okay? You've got less than 4% mortality rate. And the people who do die are already excessively elderly or in bad health already. The question that I have is, why are healthy adults acting like scared children? If for no other reason, you should be brave for your children. I mean, goodness sakes. They're seeing you freak out and look like a complete idiot for something that you probably won't even get, which brings me to my next point. No, not that point. Sorry. There. You're more likely to get a different illness. I mean, take aside the fact that they call it an epidemic, and you've got a whole bunch of things that really aren't that bad. Just throwing this out there, the cold could be characterized as an epidemic. It's sweeping the globe. Okay? People die from the cold and flus and other stuff too. That doesn't mean that it's actually something we should be afraid of, first off. If you constantly live in fear and respond to everything in fear, that's no way to live, first off. But then second off, it probably won't even happen to you. And if it does happen to you, you probably won't die. Don't be a slave of fear. I mean, goodness sakes, don't sell your whole life and to this. Oh no, we're all going to die! Because some people have died. Do you get a panic attack every single year when people start getting the flu that year? I mean, goodness sakes. There needs to be a point when you say, you know, I think honestly that the media is just trying to control us. And I'm not talking about conspiracy theories here. I'm just saying, you know, they tell us all these things of what to think and what to feel all the time. Why? Let's say worst case scenario and coronavirus is really going to kill us all. Let's just say that. Okay? How is being afraid going to profit you anything? The only thing that being afraid does is it makes you an easier prey for predators. That's it. When you're in war, what do they teach you? Keep your head. When you're hunting an animal, what do they teach you? Keep your head. All these different situations. How to not burn your house down when you've got a fire in the backyard. Keep your head. Freaking out doesn't solve anything. Have you ever been there when a woman's giving birth, going through labor? Is it scary? Yeah. Is it painful? Oh, it really does look so. I've never gone through it, but they look like they're not having a good time. Now, what good would it do freaking out and hyperventilating next to them? It would make it harder for them, but it really wouldn't fix anything, right? The exact same thing is happening here. Coronavirus. And here's the thing. A lot of people who get coronavirus, well, I shouldn't say a lot. Some people who get coronavirus don't even get symptoms. Are you listening to what I just said? Some people who get coronavirus, it goes into their system, and then it leaves their system. No symptoms. And you're telling me that I'm supposed to be afraid of that. That doesn't make sense. Don't stock up things on things that others like moms need. Now, let's kind of back up here. You shouldn't be stocking up on stuff anyways. What do you think is going to happen? Because some people got sick that there won't be food anymore in the whole world? I mean, come on. If you do stock up on something, stock up on stuff that's smart. Like, for instance, I don't know, canned foods. But here's another just thought here. If you're scared of getting the coronavirus, you might not want to go to the store to stock up on stuff because that's where all the people are and it's going to spread by – you get what I'm saying here, right? Now, also, there's a lot of misinformation on how coronavirus spreads. It's the droplets from your lungs. So, for instance, coughing, droplets. Rubbing eyes and nose. These are all things. So the best thing that you can do is wash your hands. That's the number one thing you can do. Face masks aren't going to. It may reduce your chances of, you know, spreading that kind of stuff, but it really isn't gonna make it 100% safe. There is that. But if you do stock up on stuff, make sure that you leave stuff for the other people who actually need it. Like, buying up all the wet ones? How jacked up is that? I can just imagine a new mom with her first... I have four kids, and I've... Four kids who are currently in my house. I've had other kids, too. Oh, my goodness. I can just imagine a mom who's never, or our dad, who's never had a child before, their first child, and they're all freaking out, and they're out of wet ones because, oh yeah, some inconsiderate person who's just super scared about nothing went to the store and bought all the wet ones. How silly is that? I mean, come on. Come on. There is enough if we all share and watch out for each other. Really, there is. We'll be fine. There's a part on It's a Wonderful Life where Jimmy Stewart's character is saying about how during the Black Era or whatever it's called, where the economic recession after World War One, all that's coming into my head is Black Plague, but I know it wasn't the Black Plague. Anyways, during the recession. That's good enough. When everybody was freaking out and Potter was just buying stuff up because it was a buyer's market. And so he had all this stuff because he wasn't freaking out. And he ended up on top. And that's kind of exactly what's going on here. If you freak out, it's not going to fix anything. And that's really the biggest thing is don't freak out. I mean, practice basic hygiene and you will be fine. But then also for us Christians, there's a whole other aspect that I really feel like is we're completely forgetting about. God is in control. So then there's that part of us that says, well, if God caused the coronavirus, you know, blah, 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 blah. Well, I'm not saying necessarily that God ordained the coronavirus, invented it for the purpose of afflicting us. Maybe, but that's not really my point. My point is simply this, that regardless of what comes by, God is in control. He can protect us. He can guide us. And even if he doesn't, death isn't the worst thing that can happen. I am convinced that living in a constant state of fear is worse than death. I'm convinced. Convinced. So, you know, bad things may happen, but we know who holds the future. And it's okay. Eventually, we will all die, but we don't have to die in fear. We don't have to die in fear. Now, if you notice at all, the media has quite an imagination. I mean, they tell us to be afraid of so much. We were supposed to be afraid of the Ebola virus, of swine flu, of SARS, of what was the other thing? Zika. I forgot about Zika. Let's see, what else? Y2K. Just everything. They always tell us to be, you know, super afraid of these things. The media has quite a large imagination. And it's almost never as bad as they say. So what they do is they get all these people who say, what do you project that is going to happen? So then this person comes on that says, in my estimation, this is what's going to happen. And they paint this terrible, terrible, frightening picture because that's what sells and that's what people watch because people like to be afraid. I mean, if you don't believe me, why are there so many horror movies out there that are genuinely frightening? Because people like to be afraid. So, okay. So then this analyst gets on there and says, this is definitely what's going to happen. And, you know, they paint this terrible picture. And then they're afraid of this image that they've drawn. They're afraid of their own imagination. And it's never even as bad as they say. So... there's that. I mean, there's not much else to say. Wash your hands. You probably won't get coronavirus. If you do, you probably won't die. So you see what I mean? We've got the entire population of the planet. Of this giant population, we've got this tiny bit that will actually get the coronavirus. Then we've got this tiny bit of them that will die. If anything, well, there's really no lesson to be learned here. We're being afraid of something that's just plain silly to be afraid of.